table. Have you checked the drawer? Check it very well. You better go and check the toilet as well. Check under the table. Hey, you're that four. What's up, my people? It's your girl, Adeola. If you are watching me, lift up your computer. Lift it up. Check on that, hey, you see that paper beneath that your computer? It's a suspect. In case you have not heard, we are looking for Nigeria's national budget. Don't hide it. Can you believe? By now, I have realized that Nollywood is not the only source of drama in Nigeria. In fact, Nigerian politics is way more exciting. So who stole the budget? Naija, I woke up on Tuesday only to hear that the 2016 national budget that was presented by Mr. President disappeared at the National Assembly. I said, what about the soft copy now? Kaledo said, Madam, everything disappeared, both the soft copy and the hard copy. I said, hey, what? That was part one of the movie, you know? In Nigeria, we must have part one, part two, part three. No, be so? So part two was when I heard that it was Mr. President that stole the, secretly withdrew the budget. I said, not lying. I said, no be lying. Now, these same people that told me, they said it was because he wanted to reduce some of the ridiculous allocations on their budget. You know those people like to talk, not me, you know, now then say all these things, now then say. So according to them say, Mr. President did not read the budget before submitting it for review. So when the media started shouting about the ridiculous expenses, like the money to renovate the residence of the vice president, you know, that 89 million naira they will spend on the presidential canteen. They said when the media started shouting, that was when Mr. President was aware of those bogus allocations. That was why he secretly withdrew it in order to read and make amendments. I said, hey, people, I said, beg them out. You people, you too, the yarn. Part three of the movie was when the presidential spokesperson said, hey, I beg. We didn't steal any budget. So, Mr. President did not withdraw the budget. Go and find your budget. Hey? That was a very funny one. Somehow, though, the budget reappeared at the chambers by the following day. Now, what I still don't understand is that while the rest of us were looking for this missing budget, you know, Nigerians, they were all over Twitter, you know, telling each other, when you buy your suya tonight, make sure you check the paper. It may be the missing budget. Even me in America, I was looking through my papers, you know, trying to see if I would find this budget. You just never know, because that thing may have traveled through osmosis or photosynthesis or whatever. Even Obama, American president, was looking for this budget. Remember that if anything goes missing in Nigeria, America will know. Thank you, Obama. You can put it down. Now, as I was saying, the whole time that we were looking for this budget, the Senate spokesperson, Aliyu Abdullahi, said, nah lie, no budget was missing. He said he was not aware of any missing budget. So, at the same time, the chairman House of Representative Committee on Appropriations, Abdul Mumin Jibrin, he also said there was no missing budget. So, he said, now rumor, all these things now rumor. According to him, the rumor of the missing budget may have been triggered by the delay in the production of more photocopies of the budget. I said, oh God, Nigeria. So who is lying? Was the budget missing or not? Because it was one of the senators that announced that the budget was missing. So this is what I think. Move closer. If the budget that reappeared is different from the budget that Mr. President presented in December, then somebody took it and adjusted it. No, be so? And they don't have to lie about it. Who know one better thing? If you took it and you reduced or you took away all those ridiculous expenses, we would praise you for it. No, be so? We will praise you for that. We will crucify you. So it's okay. It's okay to say, let me take it and take a second look. The only thing is, you can't just take the budget like that. You can't just take the thing like that. But these people, big mouth, they are saying maybe the presidency was ashamed of admitting that they didn't read through carefully before submitting it. I don't think anybody should be ashamed of that. Everybody makes mistakes, you know. Again, I'm not saying the presidency took the budget, so please don't quote me. I can never say that. Now, in all of this, I was really insulted. Can you believe? It really pained me. Nigerians were insulting my brother in the Lord because of the missing budget. Mr. Dino Melaye, what's up, my oga? How you there now? For some reason, the day that it was reported that the budget disappeared was the day that my oga dressed to the chambers like this. And I thought it looked great. I mean, this is probably a very expensive regalia, you know. Very nice, very good looking. I'm sure it's very expensive. But can you believe that Nigerians were saying on Twitter that the only way one can carry a document as big as our budget is to come dressed like this? I said, hey, Nigerians, they have come again, you know, enemies of progress. And you know, I actually felt bad for the man. Maoga, I think you look great, though, man, enemies of progress. Now, having said that, Nigeria, what is wrong with us? Like, really? What's that? Sometimes I feel like crying. I can't believe we are losing budget, finding budget, when we have so many pressing issues in front of us.
What can you tell us about the missing national budget?
Well, there are more pressing issues, like nobody has asked why the head in sardines is missing. You just see the body of the fish.
There is God, though. We have so many pressing issues in front of us. You know that last week, naira to dollar was like $1 to 305 naira. 305. I said, what can you believe? And not only is the price of petrol going down, which means we are no longer making money from petrol in Nigeria, but fuel scarcity continues at an alarming rate in Nigeria. People are still queuing for petrol. Honestly, I think they need to stop dragging the corruption cases in court. They need to speed them up so we can retrieve the stolen money on time and pump everything into the economy. Time is going now. We have pressing issues in front of us. But again, you guys know I don't know. I'm watching you, by the way. The budget will be under your computer. You guys know I don't know much. Guess what? I'm just keeping it real. My shout out this week goes to a Togolese scientist, Victor Abneno, living in Paris. I'm so sorry if I didn't say his name correctly. He invented the world's most affordable wireless communication system known as PWCS. This thing transmits voice, internet, yes, internet, and video connections. Now, as you guys know, using the internet is not cheap in Africa. I mean, maybe when I go to Nigeria at least. I've heard that Africa spends 3 times more than other continents to use the internet.
Africa has the most expensive broadband access in the world, with monthly data packages costing about 3 times more than on any other continent.
Benny, video takes forever to load, at least in Nigeria. And then you watch half of Keeping It Real and your data is already gone. And you know what makes this man's invention special? Users don't need to subscribe to anything, any plan. You know, there's no monthly fees. I'm telling you, this is the deal. In fact, no telecoms cables involved.
The PWC system receives a satellite data signal and is then able to disseminate the signal via PWC transmitters over great distances, making telecoms cabling unnecessary.
You have to give kudos to this man and his friends. They are not just providing data. They decided to give out countless school bags that would have solar power and a tablet in them, as well as a cell phone.
Lev, à l'intérieur, nous avons donc la tablette.
So the tablet would be powered by the solar power panels that you have installed into the backpack that every child would have.
Oui, c'est ça.
How wonderful! That way students can recharge their tablet so that they can continue working even at night. Now, this is so practical. Even if the school is under a tree, these students will be able to learn. These students can have their tablets working so long as they don't lose their backpack, their school bag. And they can charge their cell phones as well. My dear, can you call somebody? Seriously, we need to get in touch with this man. For real, if anyone knows how we can link up with this man at the KIRWA Foundation, help out your girl now. Please don't hesitate. We need to partner with somebody like this. And the best part of this is that this product was created primarily for Africans in Africa.
Nous, notre groupe que nous constituons, a des produits avec la finalité de l'usage et de l'utilité. D'abord, pour l'Afrique, si demain ça peut servir pour d'autres, il n'y a pas de problème.
Isn't that wonderful? Even though he lives in Paris, he wants his people to have access to the internet like he does. See, that is somebody that understands the meaning of empowering people, not just, you know, sending them aid. Now, you would think the whole world would be excited that finally, Africa is also getting top wireless communication system. No. Listen to this.
The PWC system has been hailed as revolutionary, and Victor has had several lucrative offers from both America and Europe to buy his patented technology.
Wow, wow, why are they trying to buy the patent of this product? Really? America and Europe? Why do you think they wanted to buy it? Yes, all of you are right. Yes, all of you are correct. But you know, the man said no.
But he has refused to sell.
J'avais voulu que pour une fois, on montre sur le continent qu'on peut inventer, accompagner une invention jusqu'à son développement et la matérialiser par l'industrialisation du produit.
Imagine how much money they must have offered this man. America and Europe. Why? This man should be celebrated for real. If he sold it to them, you know how much they would want to sell the product to people? In fact,
Colour the World is saying that they probably won't even bring it to Africa once they buy it off, you know? The sad thing is, because he refused to sell the patent, he's finding it hard to find investors.
Standing his ground has meant that Victor has been battling to secure non-commercial funding for the PwC project for several years.
Yep. I posted the full video on my blog. Make sure you watch it. I was really moved by his story. His African friends are the ones that are contributing money for him to go through with this project. It's very sad that some people are saying it's way too cheap for it to work. Can you imagine? But the thing is working. I don't even think that the government of his country, Togo, has invited him yet to bring the product. Meanwhile, the Senegalese government already invited him. So this school in this video is in Dakar, Senegal. Again, if you know how we can contact this man, please don't hesitate. And I hope that somebody in the Nigerian government is watching. Invite the man. This will solve so many of our problems. Make sure you track him down. You now do well, my brother. We are all very proud of you. Once again, you guys now don't know much. Guess what? I'm just keeping it real. So by now you've all heard about the Somali woman that wants to run for president. Yeah, so ladies and gentlemen, meet 42-year-old Fadumo Dayib, the human rights activist. She's also done some humanitarian works in Somalia, working with the UN. And as part of her preparations, she recently graduated from the Harvard Kennedy School of Government.
I'm running because I want to make a change. I want to make a difference in the lives of Somalis.
Of course, you can watch the full video on BBC. She's particularly passionate about how so many young people are leaving the country via the sea, and many of them are dying on their way. Apparently, 85% of the population in Somalia is below the age of 35. I was shocked. But you know, someone pointed out to me that, Adeola, that's the case in so many African countries. Can you believe? Now, I believe this woman is a hero, mainly because the moment she announced her intention to run, she started getting death threats. Yet, she's not giving up.
I have already been told I will be killed. I will be mutilated. They'll do all kinds of things to me. It is very strange because none of the other male candidates get death threats.
Can you imagine? Can you imagine? Because she wants to run for presidency? Hey, Wuhan! I didn't know that there are people who still look down on women like we're nothing. Huh. They must none about me. They must none about me. I hope Nigerians are getting ready, by the way, because this girl right here will be your first lady someday. By fire, by force. Shut up. Mind your business. What is your own? Now, to be honest, I'm not sure if the threats are because she's a woman or because I feel like with everything going on in Somalia, anybody that wants to make a change, the terrorists will try to kill anybody that wants to make a change. But I like this woman. Instead of being afraid, she believes that she's getting the threats mainly because she's doing something right.
Why would I get people threatening me in this fashion? So it means I must be doing something right. I must be on the right track. So yes, I will run, and they will never ever stop me from doing that. Nothing will ever stop me from doing that.
Wow. But not only that, on her Facebook page, she wrote, "What can Al-Shabaab do to a woman who has died 4 times? I died when I was born. I died when I was mutilated. I died on my wedding night. And I died when I gave birth to my first child. I am not afraid of death." Wow. I pray that this woman wins that election. Unless there's another candidate with better manifesto. But if she's the best candidate to do the job, my Somali people, do not let the fact that she's a woman and stop you from voting for a better future. Somalia has been through too much in the last decade, so this war has to stop. And if it's going to be a woman that would stop it, she has my vote. Be sure to read more about this fearless woman. And keep in mind, she's not the only one. There has been so many Somali women doing big things in Somalia, like the daughter of the late peace advocate, Elman, who was murdered several years ago in Somalia. I wouldn't be surprised if his daughter, Ilwad, becomes the president someday. Ilwad and her mom are the ones running the Elman Peace and Human Rights Center established in his honor after he was murdered. And they also have another organization known as Sister Somalia, an organization dedicated to providing support to survivors of sexual violence in Somalia. This is Ilwad speaking.
A lot of the work that we do is focused on monitoring and documenting human rights violations and abuses that are happening in the country. But we also provide services for the victims that we identify. So it's not just about collecting information, but identifying the victims and helping them to rebuild and reclaim their lives.
Girl, that's so inspiring. So to know more about Ilwad Elman, check out her inspirational story on TED Talk. You guys not know much. Guess what? I'm just keeping it real. So the photo of the day is that of South African President Jacob Zuma hugging a woman. So I want to be very careful because, you know, I don't know his relationship with this woman. Apparently, she's not one of his wives. Is she? Let me see his wives. Yes, just four of them. Anyway, so but what got my attention is where his hands are. Did you guys see one hand?
was like, anyway, never mind. I have little kids watching this thing. It may be his sister, his cousin. You never know. People can be related and interrelated. Take it now. It's enough. These are the kind of photos that you like. Now, the second picture of the day is this map. As illustrated on this map, many people have argued that if victims of tragedy are not white, Western European descent, or economically important to white people, that the level of compassion they would receive would be minimal, you know, including the number of people that would change their profile picture on Facebook. You see, you understand? Now, the question is, do you agree with this map? I would like to know. Be sure to leave your comments below. And before I leave today, I want you guys to see a little bit of Burkina Faso. So they just inaugurated a new president. How awesome is that? It's a beautiful country. Also, I'd like to give a shout out to one of our board members at KIRWA Foundation, Dr. Sesson Oluwasola. He recently celebrated his birthday. Happy birthday, my oga. Happy birthday, sir. I'm so excited because this was the man that helped us to negotiate with the hospital in India for us to pay $2,000 for them to release the Timitopoe to pay the balance from Nigeria. So we're very happy and very excited. Happy birthday. We're so proud of you. Now, before I leave, I'd like to read some of your emails. And this one is from Shoureki Kelomon. And she says, hi, Adeola. Every of our probing was a hit back to back from 1960 to 2015, from Abia to Zamfara, APC to PDP. Still, corruption never finished. Yala ya party anybody. Witch hunting take over. In Alamide's voice. And Dasuki will be like, Egbo Buhari, if you want the yam, come and take it. Very funny. I'm sure this person is trying to make fun of what happened with Nigerian music producer Don Jazzy and Olamide. Thank you very much. Every of our problem was a hit back to back. Thank you, Jari. The next email is from Colleen's Dimpa. And this person said, hi, Adeola. My fellow Nigerians, we've been patient for 55 years and the same people have been ruling us all these years. We presently have a president that ruled us over 3 decades ago. And we all need to be a little more impatient with the status quo. I believe we all need to shift the emphasis on our thinking from why the government can't create jobs to how they must create jobs. We Nigerians need to be a little more impatient, or this present government will tell us the same story after 4 years. Thank you so much, Collins. I absolutely agree with this. I feel like if we don't put fire under these people, they won't do anything. We need to move fast. See, you understand? Time no day anymore. We have to start repairing. Thank you very much. My last email is from Alhaji Mala, and he basically talked about how difficult it's been for people to withdraw money abroad. This is so sad. I get at least one email about this every day. You have no idea what people are going through. Somebody contacted me that a woman that has cancer has been in India receiving treatment and she has money, but she's not able to withdraw her own money in Nigeria. Now the hospital is telling her to leave the hospital because she couldn't afford to pay them. And she has the money in Nigeria, but they are not letting her withdraw. I really, really hope that the CBN would do something on time. So many students have been stranded for so long. Anyway, that's all the time that I have for emails today. Please keep sending your emails to adeola.keepinareal@gmail.com. Alright, y'all, it's been real. Don't forget to follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. It's been real, and I'm keeping it real right up in here. Until next week, I'ma see y'all later. Peace out.